We have a question from Trent that I don't think I've answered this kind of question in a while, so it's kind of nice to see something new and fresh. Trent says, any ideas on what I can do to improve my vertical jump so I can reach my goal of dunking a basketball? Yeah, a couple of real quick things before I go into your actual questions. First off, I'm a big believer in the hammer and stone idea from Stu McGill. So one of the things you're going to have to look at is making sure that this part of your body is hard as rock, the stone. And when I work with people sometimes who, you know, gentlemen basketball players, you know, they drink a lot of beer, they eat a lot of pizza, and then they want to talk about plyometrics. Well, really their issue is when they hit, when they stab the ground with the leaping foot, this area wobbles. So suitcase carries, any kind of core work you can do, anything that will make you strong here. And then of course, anything that can help you drive into the ground better. There are different kinds of jumpers. There is a much more, running long jump style with the big step. And then of course, the really heavy quad dominant jump that you see with a lot of volleyball players. Both will get you to the rim. Tom asked two follow-up questions. First, he asks about why I emphasize the Bulgarian goat bag swing over kettlebell swings for my older athletes. That's not necessarily true. I think you might have missed the point. If the athlete comes to me at 13, 14, 15, they're gonna learn the kettlebell swing. We're gonna take the time to teach them the swing, and they're gonna do a lot of swings. If the athlete comes to me 25, 26, 27, already has a history of injuries, already has, you know, we're towards the end of the career, the hinge movements is important. They do the hinge no matter what they're doing, but I would not necessarily say you have to do the kettlebell swing. Certainly, I would teach it if appropriate, if I have time, and I just don't always have time. And the problem is, if you do kettlebell swings wrong, I think it's like being in an auto accident over and over and over again. So I just can't recommend that. The second question Tom asks is, was I ever able to dunk? Well, yeah, of course. When I was in junior college, Eric Subert and I used to hang out with the Skyline College basketball team, who, by the way, also won the state championship along with our track team my sophomore year. And Eric and I would put on a little show for him. Eric could, he could dunk two-handed, two-footed. So he'd get underneath the rim and just jump up and dunk. And the interesting thing, he was about 5'9". I could easily dunk single-handed, especially when I was in junior college, because I was just between lifting weights at Dick Knottmeyer's and doing everything else, my body weight was just so low. I had a hard time staying at 204 to 208 because, you know, just the amount of training I was doing. So when you can snatch 265 and clean, I don't know, 335 at a body weight at 204, you can slam if you're 6 foot, it's pretty easily. So yeah, thanks for asking, Tom.